for my work in Citris project, I'm developing I've been developing the building and the simulation model, and then deliver the simulation model to Siemens to come up the control strategies optimization work. So it's a base outline of my talk. So firstly, I will give a brief introduction of my part of work, and then go through the procedure of EPLUS model development and the calibration. And also, I'll give a general introduction to the model application in demand response, and finally give some results and conclusions. For this background, the scope of this work includes OpenADI integration with the existing Siemens building and management system, FG system. And I will focus on the building modeling, simulation, and monitoring, as well as advanced demand response control strategies research. And the objective of my work is to develop an EPLUS model. So EPLUS is a simulation tool. So this tool is used to predict the whole building energy usage. And it also will be used for optimizing demand response strategies to achieve our 30% target of demand savings. At the same time, we would like to maintain the indoor comfort and also indoor air quality as well. The model will be embedded into the smart air box. So that box has, Pasad has already talked about the smart air box, and they will use the model to achieve the real-time prediction of the energy usage and optimization of demand response control strategies. Start with the EPLUS model development. So basically, we follow the standard practice of the model development. We have the building information to develop the EPLUS model as shown in the red graph. So basically, the model will describe the physical building geometry and the building construction into the model to calculate the heat transfer between the building and the outside environment. But there are too much assumptions with the initial model. For example, the space load. So we assume the occupant behavior in the model. We base on the TET24 standards to define the lighting and the plug load. And also, in terms of the building, each HVAC system component, such as supply fans, chillers, all those need to have the real operational curve to simulate the real performance of those components. So as a start point of the model development, we need to make sure we can have a better understanding of the next steps of model calibration work. We developed this model based on the thermal zoning of the VV-based control area. So for each control area, we can have the real measured data point from the building energy management system to take those data points for each VV box. For example, the minimum airflow rate, the max airflow rate, the thermostat set point. So those information will take from the building BMS and into the model. When we start to work on the model calibration work, so firstly, we have the on-site local weather station in Los Lab. We have this weather station to measure the real-time outside air temperature, relative humidity, solar radiation, wind direction, and wind speed. All those bunch of parameters come up the weather file to better simulate the heat transfer between the building and the outside environment. And then we have the key point is we have the thermometing system. For each component, we have those real measured data points for each component inside the building. And also we have the floor level thermometer lighting and plug load. So those information could be used to define the lighting densities, lighting and plug load distance, and the operational schedules in the model. And also, we did the field audit to study the occupant behavior in the building. We studied the occupant behavior in work days and also during the weekend days. So the bottom two graphs show the real operational curves of the equipment. For the supply fans, chillers, open towers, cooling towers, pumps. So those, for the initial model, we have the manufacture curve, but the real operation of those equipment perform a different way in the building. So we have those real melted point and fit those new curve to fit into the model. So basically, all those bunch of components are based on the what we have in the building and take that information into the model. But the question is, it takes too much work. So from the step of the data collection, and we did the data analysis, we did the curve fitting. All those work is, if you just base for the each component, it takes too much time to finish it. So with the help of, with the assistance of David Carlos' group, we proposed this offline automated model calibration. So we have SMAP from David Carlos' group. So SMAP can take the data point from the building measurement system. And it will transmit the data point into the SMAP. And we have the EnergyPlus model to take the data point from the SMAP and fit into the EnergyPlus model. And then we compare the simulation results, output results from the EnergyPlus model to compare with the real measured data point to have to better understand what where is the discrepancy between the simulation results and the real measured data point. And for the each component, especially for the space load and HVAC system, and also for the plant. For space load, we, as I mentioned in the last graph, you can show we have those lighting plug load, we have each component and usage from the SMAP, and then put it into the model. And we, for the HVAC system, we have those new developed curves, operation curves, and into the model. So basically, those work will be done automatically. So it directly takes the data from the SMAP and then transmit those data into the model, and then give the real-time prediction of the energy usage in Citris. So here's the general results to compare the real measured point. The blue line is the model simulation output results from the EnergyPlus, and the red line is the real measured point, the real data from the Citris. There's some missing data point, but generally, we can improve the model accuracy to within 5 to 10%. So the purpose we're trying to improve the accuracy of the simulation model is for the purpose of the demand response. So our target is to achieve 30% of demand reduction. If model gives you much higher than 20% of the simulation results, the error, it's a weak problem. So the outcome results provided to build manager could be wrong. And the build manager will make a wrong decision to implement the optimal control strategies. Once we finish the model calibration work, we use this model to predict the future building and usage using the weather forecast from the smart box. And then given the target of demand reduction, we run parametric simulations to optimize the DR control strategies. Here it shows some bunch of parameters. Sorry. So the first one is the weather patterns, and second is followed by the zone temperature set point, ventilation rate, supply temperature, condenser wall temperature. All those different parameters come up a big combination of metrics. So the simulation model will run those different combination of simulations and then get the optimal control strategies to achieve our target. For the demand response application of simulation models, accuracy of each component, not only the whole building, has to be ensured. So that's the key point to improve the accuracy of the simulation model. Secondly, simulation system play a key role in calibrating the model. Through the data point from the simulation system, we can figure out where the error, how to figure it out. And thirdly, by using the real-time data from the buildings, we can perform real-time automated model calibration. It can reduce the effort to develop the model, and meanwhile, it will increase the model accuracy. Yep. Thanks. That's what I have.